Tada! So, as you can see, I'm back here with my finished little card art journal. I just took all the cards from before and made a one signature journal out of it. So as you can see, I took all the cards and yeah, put them together and made a really simple three-hole binding here with this red and white thread. For the closure, I used the same thread from the binding. I left it a little bit longer, and as you can see, here's this little paper clip with this little woolen tassel on it. And you can just take this little guy here, take that out, and then bring this here to the back side, remove this whole stuff. And then you will see this is in the middle here of the signature. You can now open the journal. So this little guy here will stay here on the front side. You can open it. And in the middle, you see that this thing here that I've used for the closure is just the thread that comes out from the binding here in the middle hole. When you make this three-hole binding. And I left it a little bit longer, as I said, so that when I close it, it stays here. And I can just wrap it around here. And leave it like it is, like this. Or I can wrap it around and close it here with this little paper clip, as you've seen before. So now I can take it where I want it and nothing will fall out of it. So I used many fuzzy cut images here, like little butterflies and that stuff. I have some left over here. So when you have such things and you have a closure like this, that's really sensible because you can put these things inside and nothing will fall out when you take this journal with you on a trip or somewhere else, or you put it into your bag. Then you can put all the stuff inside and nothing will come out because the pages are a little bit more pressed together. Okay, so let's open it up again and let's just make a little flip through of this whole thing. And before I start, I want to say I used really simple supplies. I used what I have here in my kitchen because, as you know, I'm not at my crafty area at the moment. So I used what I had at hand. So this little book pages here, this butterfly cutouts come from my butterfly flowers printable kit. There are two of those pages to cut out. So one with the butterflies and one with the flowers. So I printed this out. And yeah, as you can see, sometimes we have this really weird things here on the other pages, but I don't care about that. I see many people on YouTube who are really art journaling experts, and they use those pages here as the base for their new pages. So I tried to get something like this as well here in my journal. So this is, by the way, the first really art journal I tried to make. I have something like a notebook where I have some art journaling pages in it, but I have no real art journal. So this is the first. I don't know if I made everything right, but for me it's a really cool inspiration to have this, especially this contrasts of those really messy pages and then such clear things like this. As you can see, here I also included a page that was a fail. I tried to make some lines with a white pen, but it smeared around, and I left it here, not only because it was the back side of this one here, but also because I want to try this out, that you can have a page that's something like a fail and you make something new out of it. So I left all those messy and fail pages here inside. And I have to say, this is one of my favorites. So yeah, I think that turned out so cool. And when you imagine how less supplies I used for this page, I think, yeah, it turned out really beautiful. So leave me a comment if you see that the same way like me, or if you think, okay, that's a whole shit, I would never do it like this. I would be really happy to know your thoughts about that. And as you can see, here are many pages where I haven't done anything until now. I tried out some collaging here on the brush of things and that stuff. And I have this page here in the near of this one so that I also can compare things and try out similar things on a similar background or something like that. And through the whole journal, I tried to get a something like an order from the colors. So as you can see, when we start here, we have this orange here. It goes on with the orange, then here the orange, and yeah, turns into this little yellow, and the green goes on with the green and all the green things. Then yeah, it turns to this brown things. And so I tried to get a little like a rainbow thing through this whole journal. So this brown here is here again, and this green goes on here. Here it is not so successful. I think I have to do something here in this color to get this color bridge here as well. So I tried to get this colors into something like an order or something like that. And I also included this leftovers from the cards that I've cut. So as I said, one of those cards here was a DNA 4 page. I've cut it into the size of the stencil so that I can fold it into half. So this is the size of the stencil, and every card is folded like this. And the leftover of the piece of paper, I have some of them here in the journal as well. I only clip this with a paper clip. So as you can see, you can remove it like this, and you can use it for a greeting card. You can use it to make some doodlings or something like that. Here I see a really cool flower lawn or something like that. And you can take that out, finish it and put that back, or you can give it away. You can gift it to someone, or you can also cut it here and make two pockets, two belly bands or something like that. So I wanted to have it a little bit flexible to make some different things that you can make in an art journal. Of course, you can also use this to make a little paper pad for some notes or something like that. I have another one that's not such weird here on one of the other pages, and I think that can be a really cool thing as well. So here it is. So my golden color holds it here. You can also make a paper pad or some notepad out of this. Just take some notepaper and make a little something like a signature here, and then you can put it back here and make some notes for your art journal, or yeah, to make a shopping list or whatever. So in this case, of course, it would make more sense to make notes about the art journal, but yeah, you can use it for the reason you want it. Here, I have to say, this is not finished. I took, and that was, okay, slowly, Luise, slowly. This was the page where this thing with the repositionable spraying glue failed. And I had the problem that here around the corner, that was very sticky. So I had to find a solution to protect this, that when I take my page here and turn it over, that it doesn't stick here to this other page. So I took this little tag here, that's a corrugated cardstock tag, and I've put it here into this corner, protected here this little edge, because here, of course, is this little thing on the other side. Here it was sticky as well. And I put some washi tape here, and at the same time, this thing is a pocket so that I can put some tiny things here inside, and so that I can take them with me. But this page here is not finished until now. But I also thought I would try to start some things and Yeah, I've put some washi tape here as well because of this sticky problem, and I thought, okay, let's put this children here on top and let's see on another day what comes to my mind that I can make this to a whole beautiful art journal page. And the same stuff with all the other things that you can see here in this journal. I have some blank pages as well because, yeah, of the backside of the cards and that stuff. And I've not decided until now what to do with this. So as I said, I see some mermaids here or some blue butterflies or something like that. But of course, it's not possible to fill a whole art journal like this in one day or something like that. So I tried to get some points of interest here to my pages and also to the mocha pages, as I said. So for example, this one here, I think that turned out really, really great, but it can happen that I will add some black circles, or that I will stencil over it with another stencil, or that I put a label here. So yeah, I think I will do that. But I wanted to have a base for something. I wanted to have a base for some inspiration, a base for some daily art and that stuff, and that you don't have to start with a blank page. So I think that's a main point about art journaling, that you have some already some inspiration in such a kind of journal. And I tried to leave it in this small size. As you can see, it's only the size of this stencil. With this small size, I think I'm really happy, because when I want to try out things and I want to use my paints or something like that, then I have a small thing to do. And I'm not an expert. I'm a totally beginner at art journaling and that stuff. And I think it's also a point of wasting supplies, wasting materials, wasting paint and that stuff. And when I make something like this and I think, okay, a fail, so not this, of course, I love this very much, but when I have a failed page, I, of course, haven't wasted so much paint when I have such a tiny small journal like this. And I think that's a really important point for me, because, yeah, I have not such much money to spend in acrylic paints and all that stuff, in that structure paste stuff and that things. So that it's really cool to have such a small thing to work in. Okay, so to bring this thing here to another level, I decided that I want to make a little bag for this journal out of the protection paper of my table here. As you can see here, I have this protection paper, and I think it would be really cool to have a little something like a bag to put this little journal in. And as you can see, that fits really well together, of course, because here are all the leftover paints that I have in the journal here. And yeah, I thought, let's make a little bag. Until now, I have no idea how I can manage that, because of course I have this paper here only one time and I'm filming it nearly live or something like that. I couldn't plan that, because I can't reproduce such a paper again. So let me show you that from another angle. It's really cool. And I think it's hard to get such a pattern or such paint things planned. So when you have such a paper here, so this is just such an Amazon packaging paper, where they protect the items that they send to you. I think I wouldn't be able to get this here planned to such a paper, and especially not in the colors and the mediums of this journal here. So let's try that. For this, I just want to check the size of this thing. And I have to say, I have no sewing machine at the moment here, because my sewing machine is at the sewing machine doctor, and the sewing machine doctor is in Germany. I'm in Austria, and he will be not allowed until the middle of June to come here to repair my sewing machine. So that's a really big problem, but I think we can glue that as well. But if I had my sewing machine here, I would do it with a sewing machine. So if you want to craft along with me, perhaps you would like to sew it. yeah, so we have to get the measurements of this thing here. So as you can see, it's only a little bit around here of this journal. And I'm just thinking about using the stencil again and making some more patterns in this style, just to bring it a little bit more together and to bring it in the context with this stencil. I have some leftover golden paint here on my beauty blender here that I used for distressing the edges of the journal. So this is still a little bit wet. So let me take that and just go over it here. But I think that will be not enough. No. Okay, so where's the golden paint? I just take this here. And let's take a little bit out of it. So perhaps with this knife can be a cool idea as well. Looks. I just have to say, I have a new lamp here, a new light source, just here over my head, and sometimes I think I have to wear sunglasses, and it's a little bit hard to handle. Hopefully the frame is a little bit better than before, and the picture that you can see on your screen. Yeah, so hopefully you can't see what I see through my camera. That looks really weird, but I think it gives it a really cool structure. So I take this the other way around and just bring this here. And I'm always surprised about the people who do all that stuff such intuitive. They mess around with some supplies and colors and that stuff, and they get such really results that I can sometimes not understand how that is possible. So sometimes I would like to try that by myself, but I think it's a lot of practice. It looks so easy when they do that. Okay, that looks really nice. It looks really easy when they do that, but when you try that by yourself and you spritz or splatter your paint, then you see, okay, that's not so easy. It looks easy, but it's not so easy. But I always encourage myself to try new things and to try that stuff out, what they do in these videos and where I can see it. So I would like to encourage you to do that. And I just have to pick my gesso. Okay, so let's just take some white gesso as well. So I'm going around here with this stuff. Even if I don't know if I will need this whole piece of paper. Until now, I don't know that. I have something like a plan in my head how I want to do that, but not such clear that I can explain every step to you. And sorry, I just have to run here around in my kitchen for a moment, because some of my supplies are in a little basket. That's all I have here at the moment. And I'm a little bit confused and I don't know. I think this orange was really cool, but I think I also can't reproduce that. So let's take little bit of this white thing. I think that's a really cool contrast to this whole thing. And I want this, again, I want this stencil to be shown on the outside of this little bag that I planned here to do. So everything inside is made with this one stencil, so that I hope to get an imagination of this to the outside of this bag. But now I think it looks really... So this is a really strange thing. It looks a little bit too planned for me at the moment. But oh yes. And of course you can also use what you have left over here to make some scraps, to make some clusters or that stuff. And even if you don't need the whole thing here, you can of course take that to make some other pieces of art. And that's the reason why I'm going here in this bigger dimension here over this whole thing, so that I have more possibilities to choose on the one side to choose the thing that I want to use for my bag, so the plant project, and that I also have some stuff that I can use for other things as well. So for example, it would be, I think, a cool idea to take these things and make little scraps from the leftovers and use them in the journal. And so you have another kind of stenciling here that you can use inside. Okay, so that's nice, but I think it's not messy enough for me. And I also miss those colors that I have inside of the journal. So this kind of thing here, that's the purple brush from one of the pages, and this blue as well. And hopefully, so I haven't dried my gesso until now, hopefully this will not destroy my pattern there, but even if it will be destroyed, I think it's not so bad, because then we have perhaps something like a more loose thing at the end. Here this is really straight and perhaps not so nice. So I don't know what will happen now. I never did that before, but let's just bring this out of the way and spray some water. Mommy. Okay, so this stays in place. I have the feeling that this stays in place, but I don't like the brushes when they are such single colors, like you can see them here. So I add much more water, and then I will use my heat gun. Hopefully my kitchen is not a rainbow after that, but I want to bring this wet colors into the spaces here, the little slots of the gessoed thing here, and I want to bring them together a little bit more. In the camera it looks really cool, I think. Whew! Oh my god. Oh my god. Ich hab so Angst. Okay, so you need a paper towel for this, definitely, not to get the paint onto your table or something like that, because it's really hard to remove. God, I'm so nervous. Is the camera recording? Yes. Only one try for this. Okay, so that's really cool, isn't it? So oh my gosh. I love it so much. So as you can see, it's not completely dry, but it's really wavy. So I decided to take a baking paper, place this on top, and iron this whole stuff a little bit so that I get less problems when I want to bring this into this paper bag shape later. Hopefully nothing will stick here, but that seems to work. As I said, I never did this before. Yeah, hopefully that brings this paper in a little bit more flat condition. Okay, so I place it here, and the plan is to get, so let me just cut this off here because it's two layers of this paper, so I just cut the top layer off. I want to have this side here because I think that looks more interesting. So I try to find the position, so when you make it like this, then you can see, okay, this here will be on the other side of this whole thing. So I make it like this, and here out of my camera frame I have the original edge of the paper. So I line it up that I have a straight line. Do it like this, take this out and fold it like this. Okay, so then I put this back inside, and please excuse this noises in the background. That's my kitchen fire, so hopefully it's not too loud, but it's such cold outside today that I had to make a fire here. Okay, so now we have this. Take this off. This, and I want to have also some kind of space in this little bag, so I'm just trying to figure out how big this can be, that the journal will fit inside, but also that I also have some space left for my pen, and if I want to make some doodling outside and on my way or something like that, then I want to have some space in this little bag where I can put my pens in and that stuff. So I think that's not too bad. Yeah. So now let's do it like this. And now I think I can decide what shall be on the front or the back. Sorry, I can't speak and do these things. I think that should fit. Okay, so now I will let's try it like this. So just do it like this. And like this. And I just let this overlap a little bit so that I can glue it there. Okay. I think that should be enough. Okay, so now this here is the original frame, the original cutting. And of course, here I have my cutting that I made with my scissors and I eyeballed it. So I just take this and make it like this. And then the other way around to get, yeah, something like a nice looking edge here. And if I have my, sewing machine here, of course, I can sew here now before gluing it. But as I said, I don't have a sewing machine here. So yeah, let's just glue it. So perhaps we can take the baking paper from before, do it like this, so that I don't get glue into this inside. Not so bad. Then from the other side, now it looks like this. So now I will take this baking paper out and I will fold this here like this to create a little space that the journal can fit into. And I will make it a little bit bigger than it is necessary. As I said, I want to store some supplies in there as well when I take the journal with me, or when I have some plans for a new journal page that I can put everything inside. So I make this a little bit bigger than it is necessary for the thickness of this journal. Okay, so now let's take this little edge here, fold it like this. Of course, you can take a bone folder or something like that to flatten this, but I don't have one here at the moment. But with your fingernail, it's also possible. Okay, so make sure that this is really flat. Then we take this like so, open this little thing here and bring this both pieces here like so. Then let's take this and fold it here approximately to the half of this thing here that crosses this line. So yeah, can you see the line? I don't know. So here's this middle line from the, yeah, from this fold, and I take this and bring it approximately to the middle here of this thing, and the same on the other side. Like so, and then the same with this little guy here, and this will, as you can see, overlap a little bit here. Just have to bring this back. And this is something that you, yeah, don't know if you can measure that, but it should be something like regular. So now This thing here is looking a little bit, not so nice, but we can do it like this so that we have the printed thing here on top. Then we will put glue. As you can see, you have this here only to this little thing here. I think, yes. And here. Then do it like this. And then we will glue this here. So I add some of my glue to these little triangles here. Little bit here on the top. Now looks like this, and you can see it's like the bottom of a normal paper bag. So of course you also can do can make a paper bag like this. Doesn't have to be such a bag for a journal. You can also fill it with sweets or something like that. I will show you in a minute how that looks. Let me just let this dry a little bit. Okay, so now this is dry. You can see when you open this up, you already have something like a bottom here. So, looks like this, and this is the width of this or the thickness of this little bag. But I also want to have something on the side here that allows me to bring this journal in. So I'm orientating here on this little thing here. As you can see, you have this little point here that comes to the rest here, and you have here this little triangle, and this point and this point is your orientation for the next fold. So I take this, let me just bring the camera a little bit more down that you can see that exactly what I'm doing here. Sorry. So I take it here and here, and then so you can also, sorry, no, it's also turn it to the other side. So doesn't that look gorgeous? So I love this. You can also take this to the other side so that you can see it a little bit better. So when you turn this over, then you have this little thing here that you can see exactly where you have to fold. Then you make it like this and fold this the whole length. Something like parallel to the rest. And the same thing on the other side. So that's the back side. I'm looking here to this little edge and then fold it as much this until I can see this thing here, like this. And now, let me just bring you back again here that you can see it a little bit better. Now we can open this, so flip this back a little bit and then open it like this, and you can see all these folds here now. Really nice. Now we have to bring this little fold to the inside, so we have to fold it the other way around. For that, I have my arm here inside of this thing, and I get this here carefully. So of course with the gesso on it, it's not so easy, so do it that carefully. I bring this to the other side, so that I can press this inside and bring that fold to the other way. So that's, yeah, nearly the same way a normal paper bag is folded. Then it looks like this. On the other side, I will do the same. I put my arm inside here and try to get that middle fold to the other direction. And I don't care about these little mistakes here because, yeah, it's an art journaling bag and not, sorry, and not something that is really clear and nice and that stuff. Okay, so now we have this bag with the possibility to put things inside that are that thick like this. And let's just try if our journal fits into here. So I'm always saying our journal, so of course it's my journal, but yeah, I know you watch this video and that's of course cool, and I always have the feeling that you are here with me, so it's not only my journal but our journal. I don't know. And now you can see this opens up like the width of this journal is. It's also, no, not the width, the thickness. So that you can place it like it would be in there when you take this with you. Press this down a little bit so that you can decide how you would make to how you would like to make the closure. So I think I would like to do it like this. Let it flip to the back side, because then I have this looking thing here, this optic on the front side. So the bottom now is here. Later on it can be like this, or you can also do it like this, like so. Let's do it like this. Just cut this little thing here off. Like so. Okay, so one really easy possibility to close that would be to fold it like this, so that you have a really nice thing here. Of course, you can cut that here, but I like it like this, so that we have this really nice line here. Then you can take such a flexible string, how is this called? This is made out of gum. And yeah. You can put it like this here to this thing, and it looks, I think, really nice. You can also use this to put some things under it, so to clip this here, for example, when it's a windy day or something like that and you are outside, you also can clip this here when you are working in your journal, so that nothing can fly away or something like that. And at the same time, this thing would be closed. But you know me, I'm always a friend of some special things. So of course, you can also put an eyelet or something like that here, but of course, only to the first layer of this. So otherwise you would of course close this here, but there are many possibilities to make that. Another one would be to put, where is it, something like this here to the first layer of this whole stuff. So we would open it up like this and put a hole here and then put this little guy here inside. So that's a normal, you know, one of these little clamps where you can close an envelope normally. But I would recommend to put a cardstock here. Oh, sorry, I'm out of frame. Focus, I mean. You can put a little piece of cardstock here and then put this here. So perhaps I will decide to do that so that you can see it. Yes, let's do that. I'm just thinking about if I can use this as well. Yeah, let's try it. So I have to say what I'm using here today are my really last pieces of material, so that can look a little bit strange perhaps. So I will take this here instead of a piece of cardstock and make several layers out of it, because I think I don't have a cardstock here anymore. But when you do this for your journal, please take something really sturdy. Let's do it like this. Because you don't want, when you wrap string around this, that this breaks out. And perhaps you think, okay, COVID-19 is over. What is she talking about there? It may be that this video goes online after this whole situation and the lockdown situation is already a little bit more loose and open. But I'm recording some videos here at the moment. Where's my... Sorry, I just have to run through my kitchen. What I wanted to say is I'm just recording some videos for the summer, so that you have to watch something during the summer month where I have to work in my main job, as you perhaps know. And I have some content prepared, so it may be that when you see this video, that the weird situation with the COVID thing is already, yeah, over and a little bit more controllable. So please don't think I'm the only one who is in this situation for the rest of the year, but I don't know, yeah, what to say in this video, because I don't know when this will be online. So now this is an imitation of a little piece of cardstock, really sturdy. When this is dry, I think that's okay. And now let's bring that to the position where we want it. So perhaps it would look really great like this, with this inside later. And I'm just thinking about putting a butterfly here on top. I think that would be a great idea. And I also have some sari silk here that I want to use for that. So let's try that. I take a pencil and I'm just eyeballing this, that I know where I have to make my hole, and then go in with my fingers here, taking this little guy here, making a little hole just through the first layer of this. Don't hurt your hands when you do that. Then I'm placing it here, and the butterfly gets a little hole in the middle here as well. Of course, you can use something to protect this surface here, but you can also remove it every later when I I'm totally confused because of this thing. Ah, later when I'm back in my caravan, I can remove this and put something to protect this fuzzy cut image, that it don't tears off here. Now I can take it like this and put this here just through the hole that I made before, like this. And then inside with my fingers, I'm just bringing the little wings of this clamp in the position they are meant to be, like this. So now it looks like this. There inside you can see this little wings of the clamp, and they are only in this piece here so that you can open this up and take your journal out. Whew. And when it's closed, it looks like this, and it's also a little bit flexible, but that's good because now let's wrap around a little bit of sari silk. Because I think that will look really cool. So let me just measure some. I think the little bit more of the double length of this will be enough. And then I take the one thing here, put it behind this cardstock thing. I think I want it like this to the side. Make a little knot here, like this. And then I can just do it like this, and then I have this cool thing here. Of course, you can also do it like this or like this, wherever you want to have it. Now we can bring this to this position, and this here goes behind this, and you can also wrap it around here several times, for example, like this. Or you can make a little something like this that you can open up later. Or, of course, you can also add another butterfly here, wrap it around like this or something like that. Or you can take this thing and go around here at the end so that you have this little thing here wrapped around a little bit. And now, of course, it's possible that you can't remember that this is the thing that you can take off and this is the thing that you wrapped around here. So take something that you can put here, for example, this one, and then you know I can take it off. This is a little bit too big for me, but what's also a good thing would be a bulb pin. So let me just take one out here. You can take this here, this little guy, and bring it here to the end of the sari silk so that you know that this thing is the thing that you can take to unwrap this. And I think this also looks really nice. So now you can take it, do it like this, take this whole thing off, like this, open it up, and take your art journal out. My nerves really have gone with this thing. hopefully we will see the next time. Hopefully this was a little bit of something, something like an inspiration or something like that. I can't talk anymore. I'm so happy that I came up with this, and I'm really happy that I haven't destroyed it. I think now I definitely have to eat something because it's 3 o'clock in the afternoon and I haven't eaten something today. I think I'm a little bit like this, but I wanted to record this video. I have to say, I love you all so much and thank you for watching again this little video here. Hopefully we will see the next time, and until then I wish you a really good and really happy crafty time, perhaps with some things of this. I'm at the end of my nerves and at the end of my words now. So I wish you a really great time and see you the next time. So bye bye.